I have been having a good time, and all the fans have been great and very interesting. So for me, it's a lot of fun. Done probably everything. I've had fire burns and high falls and fights and car stunts, sword fighting, and just quite a bit. You know, if you've been at it as long as I have and you've made a living in it, you're going to have to be able to do most of everything. So I guess I have. The main thing is, of course, you have to have generally physical abilities, athletic abilities. But beyond that, for a good stuntman, you have to use your head. You got to be careful. Your safety is your first concern. And then you have to have some people skills, because there's a lot of things to get along with when you're doing a film. And then just setting up a stunt and working with the other stunt guys, it takes a little bit of that teamwork and ability to, back up your buddies and get help from them when you need it. It's true that of all the things I've done, it seems that the horror movies have been the most popular, which is a surprise, because when I was doing them, of course, I thought it was just another film, another job, a good, interesting job, but I had no idea it would be anything quite as popular years later. I don't know. Some of the things we did were unusual, because it's not a regular stunt when you, take an axe to somebody or have a chainsaw fight. But it was all interesting. For instance, I had to use an axe and stick it in the head of a prosthetic face, and that's kind of creepy. But, it's all part of the deal. One of the most interesting stunts is in Friday the 13th, I got hit by a front loader. And to set that up was kind of fun, because I could work it out and it was real. It wasn't, it wasn't a computer generated thing. We did the actual hit and I got to fly through the air and hit the ground, and that was kind of fun. When we did Ghostbusters, that was when probably computer graphic was sort of starting, and so we had no idea at the time. They were shooting just against the walls and we couldn't see the ghosts, so that was kind of unusual. We didn't know what they were doing. As a matter of fact, I remember talking with a stunt coordinator. He says, this movie, I don't know, it may not even come out. I don't know what's going on. But we had some good shots and we had some good times with it, and for me to double Harold Ramis was kind of special, and working with Aykroyd and the others, that was kind of a pleasure. But it was like anything else, you have your gags to do and you had to get those done right. But at the time, we had no idea it was going to be a classic. I started with Star Trek in the 70s doing Star Trek the Motion Picture, where I doubled Leonard Nimoy. So that was a kind of a neat start for me. And then I did all the following series, Deep Space Nine, Voyager, Enterprise, Next Generation. And so I did a lot of makeup work, and it takes a little bit of patience, and you got to just put up with that kind of makeup. And after a while, if you do get used to it, you can do the work. But I was fortunate that my particular skin could take the glue quite well. So when they apply makeup to me and put prosthetic pieces on, it stayed held up pretty good. And with stunt guys, you do a lot of action, and it gets real sweaty, and it's hard to keep that makeup looking good. But I was fortunate that I needed lots of touch-ups, so I was pretty popular with the makeup people.
And when you're doubling someone like Harold or Leonard, how closely do you work with them to try and match their performance? Because obviously you're not just doing a stunt, you're effectively forming a part of their overall performance.
Well, that's something people don't necessarily pay attention to, but a good stuntman will be able to mimic the person they're acting or covering. And occasionally, you do have to do a little bit of practice on certain movements. I know when I doubled Jeff Goldblum, he has certain mannerisms that I had to get used to. But the more you can do, the closer you can look like the actor, it makes it a lot better for the editors, because whatever the actor is doing before the action starts, you have to overlap it somewhat. Once you're flying through the air, there's no real problem with it. But in between, it's real helpful if you can match some of their moves.